Hello, happy Sunday, great people. I welcome you to the first edition of the Sunday Mobile Church with Evangelist Mark Miracle. It's always a pleasure to have you on the Pure Gospel Moment. And this Sunday, we are discussing about the power of diligence. We are talking about the power of diligence, what diligence can do for you in your place of work, in your family, in everything you want to have a maximum result from. You have to apply the power of diligence. Diligence means consciousness in paying proper attention to a task. It means consciousness in paying proper attention to a task. I don't know what the task may be. I don't know what you are doing, what you are after, what you are running after. Have you applied the power of diligence? Reward comes only to those who pay diligence or who give diligence to the task they are given. You know, to be diligent takes the whole of your heart. It takes the whole of your mind and it takes the whole of your being. For you to be diligent and for you to have a maximum reward in that thing you are pursuing. The book of Proverbs chapter 13 verse 4 says, "The soul of the sluggard craves and gets nothing, while the soul of the diligent is richly supplied." The soul of the sluggard craves and gets nothing. You see, people run after many things. They run after things in life and they keep on complaining that there is no result. It is not yielding result. I'm doing this. Have you applied the power of diligence? Colossians chapter 3 verse 23. Whatever you do, whatsoever you do, work heartily as for the Lord and not for men. Work heartily. That's why I said from the beginning that diligence has to do with the whole of your heart. Where are you fixing your heart on? What are you fixing your mind on? You see, the major focus in our topic today, diligence, is diligence, because diligence is the only thing that it takes for you to have a maximum reward. That is why we are focusing on it today, this very Sunday. Like I said yesterday on my post, I said we are going to use every letter in the spelling of the word diligence to explain how we are going to be diligent. And I believe that this Sunday will be a blessing. This Sunday will be an eye-opener to every one of us as we apply each and every of this letter that God is going to reveal to us. Now, D in diligence is what I have tagged devotedness. You devote your time. The letter D in diligence means to devote your time. How do you become diligent to your business? How do you become diligent to your home, to your family, to what God has placed in your hands? D, you have to devote your time. Devote your time. We all know that everything in this life takes time. To be with your family, it takes time. To be with the work in your hand, it takes time. Then everyone keeps on saying that they don't have time. You ask people to do this, they will tell you, "I don't have time." But there is something I tell you, that time is money. Everyone says it, that time is money. Would you want to misplace your money? Would you want to throw away your money? Or would you want someone to steal your money? No. Now, treat your time as if it is money. For you to know that diligence is actually working, that your diligence is on high frequency, you will know that by always seeing that you don't joke with time. When you don't joke with time, when you don't play with time, when you miss out something that is very, very important to you, you see it as if you lost money. That is how you begin to know that time is important to you. And that is why what I mean by devoting your time. The next letter in diligence is I. It means invest in your assignment. I means to invest in your assignment monetarily. There are little things that you can do to invest in your assignment. You can invest by buying and reading books that has to do with that assignment that God has given you. You can invest in you are doing fashion, you are doing you're a producer, you are into ministry, you are into anything that has to do with what will put food on your table. How much more have you invested on that work in your hands? Have you ever thought of investing part of your income to that source of income? Now you are making money from it. Don't starve that source of income without investing on it. Now, for you to know that you are diligent enough in that thing God has given to you, you should be able to invest on it. The next letter in diligence is L. It means love. Love what you are doing right now. You can't say you are diligent in your assignment. You can't say you are diligent in your family. Okay, how do you say you are diligent about your family? You are diligent about your wife when you don't show love? You don't love them. You say you're a market woman, you're a producer. When I say producer, maybe you produce music, you produce video, you produce shoes, you are a fashion designer, and you don't show love. When it is time for you to go to do what you have to do to put food on your table, you can't do it with love. It doesn't flow. That means you lack diligence in that assignment. You have to show love. You have to love what you do for you to be able to say that you are diligent in that assignment. The next letter in diligence is I, which means introduce your hobbies to your work. Introduce your hobbies to your work. Now, when you go when somebody asks you, what is your hobby? No, you're working. Let me say, for instance, you are doing a white collar job. You sit in the office, you input things on the computer, you do output, input on your computer and all the rest. Now, aside that, they ask you, what is your hobby? You say it's swimming. You say your hobby is reading. You say your hobby is traveling. Now, what do I mean by inputting your hobby, introducing your hobby to your work? Your work is different from your hobby, but you love your hobby. Everyone loves his or her hobby. For your work to be smooth, for your work to yield more results, introduce that aspect of your hobby to your work. You love playing, you love reading. Now, love your work the way you love reading. See your work to be part of your hobby. That is what I mean by introducing your hobby to your work. That is how to show diligence to your work. Oh, that work is stressful. It's stressful. Just put your mind, refocus your mind. Just assume you are traveling if your hobby is traveling. Just assume you are swimming if your hobby is swimming. Now introduce that hobby to your work. Introduce that hobby to your assignment. Oh, my hobby is traveling all around. Now, when you are sitting in that desk, you are feeling tired. Just introduce that hobby. Put your mind that you are traveling on that desk. Put your mind that you are moving around the world. That is what I mean by introduce that thing you love. Introduce your hobby to your assignment. Introduce your hobby to your work, and you will see that it will yield maximum results as the power of diligence is needed. The next letter is G. Give back to God and to the society. For you to be diligent in your assignment, you have to give back. Whatever your assignment has given to you, give it back to God and to society. Now you're a fashion designer. Not every time you make clothes for money, give back to the society. You're a graphic designer. Not every time you design for money, give back to the society. You are a shoemaker. Not every time you make shoe for money, give back to the society, give back to God. You're a preacher. Not every time you go to preach because they pay you, go and preach for free for sometimes. You are whatsoever thing you want to say, give back. That is what that letter means. Give back. It means you are diligent. You are diligent enough to know that this thing you are doing, God gave it to you. So you are giving it back to the society, and you are giving it back to God himself. The next letter in diligence is E. It means endure. Endure the pains. Oh God, you asked me to do this. I am doing it. It's not yielding result. Endure the pain. Oh God, you said that you directed me to go and learn this. I have learned it. It's not yielding. Endure the pains. Oh God, you told me to leave this and enter this. It is not yielding results. Why did I leave? Endure the pains. Endure the pains. The days of little beginning can never be downplayed. As long as the power of diligence is concerned, you must endure the pain. You feel like it's no longer working. You feel like it's not. Subdue that spirit. Endure the pains. That is what it takes to be diligent. The next letter in diligence is, you know why I'm smiling? That is just an expo. When I preach like this, my wife is sitting in front of me, so I just looked at her and I smiled. Now let's go back to the business. God bless you. Now the next letter in diligence is N. Never mistake diligence for intelligence. N means never mistake diligence for intelligence. Constantly improve yourself. Constantly seek and get more knowledge in the area of your assignment. Oh, you are intelligent. I learned this in school. I do this in school. So for your, because you are intelligent does not mean that you are diligent. Never mistaking diligence for intelligence. You are good. You know it. Yes. But you have to be diligent. You have to be head lowered. You have to lower your head for you to yield result. And that thing, for you not to make mistake out of pride. The next letter in diligence is C. You know what I tagged it? CV review. The next letter is C. CV review. Before applicants get employed, they fill all manner of things in their CVs, such as in the skills, they say they are reliable, they are innovative, they are dependent, they are fast workers, etc., etc. But after getting the job, do we really keep to do all that? Do what your CV says you can do. You know, after submitting that CV, they've taken it, the human resource officer files the CV. Everybody forget that your objective in that CV is to be dependable, to be innovative, and to be reliable. See your CV as your personal oath. It's an oath you took. You said you are reliable. You said you are dependable. Now revisit your CV and do exactly what your CV said. It might not be a workplace. In your family, you said, I will love. On the altar, you said, I will love you till death do you part. Now, are you still loving her that way? That is your curriculum vitae. Personally, revisit those things you have said to yourself. Revisit them again and see how it yields result. That is how to be diligent. The last letter in diligence is E. Engrave yourself in your assignment. Let the next person who comes to take over your job, let the next person who comes to take over the last place you sat, let the next person who comes to take over the last thing you did, see that it will take grace for him to undo what you have done. It will take grace for him to now imprint a touch of excellence, imprint a touch of maximum productivity in everything you've done. In your family, in the home, in the society, engrave yourself in that assignment. This is how to be diligent in your assignment, in your home, in your family. This is the word God has given me to share this Sunday. It's like I told you, it's a Sunday mobile church. Wherever you are, it's the church. The church is not the building. The church is not the construction. These buildings are the things that houses the church itself. You are the church. I am the church. So, haven't gone to church and come back today, or those who haven't gone already, this is also a church. And I believe that this message has blessed you. I close with this scripture, Galatians chapter 6, verse 9. And let us not grow weary of doing good, for in due season we will reap if we do not give up, if we continually become diligent. You will reap that thing that you have been diligent upon. And I believe that your testimony is there. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this short word you have given us this Sunday. Thank you for the word you have given us on the mobile church. I believe that this word will change each and every heart, each and everyone that has listened to it. I believe so, that it has changed every, just like it has touched me, just like it has touched my family, just like it has touched everyone around that is listening, the same way it is touching everyone that is watching. And I believe that people will call in for testimonies. Blessed be your holy name, Jesus. For I know that you have started this and testimony will follow suit. Blessed be your holy name. If you have not accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I come unto you. I know that every man has a sinful nature. And I confess that I have sinned and come short of your glory. I confess that Jesus is Lord and He died to save me from sin. Forgive my sins. Remove my name from the book of death and put it in the book of life. I will serve you all the days of my life. In Jesus' name.
We believe you were blessed with today's episode of Pure Gospel Moment. For prayers, testimonies, or further inquiries, you can reach Mac Miracle on +234 812 328 8593. That is plus 234-812-328-8593. God bless you real good.